So how did you start your day today?
I had a nice cup of tea and I went for a swim.
If Harley Quinn only knew what Margot Robbie is worth, she'd rob her too. Don't believe me? Well, keep on watching to find out just how much Margot Robbie makes in a year and how she likes to spend her money. Apparently, she spends thousands of dollars every month for a very heartbreaking reason. But before we get to that, make sure you leave a like on this video and hit the subscribe button with notifications turned on so you don't miss any of the new videos we post. So let's get straight to the point. As of March 2021, Margot Robbie's estimated net worth stands at a whopping $26 million. Wondering how the heck she became so rich? Well, her double role as actress and producer for the film Birds of Prey could be credited for a sizable portion of that fortune. According to Variety, Margot Robbie made as much as $10 million for Birds of Prey. To put this into context, you should know that Joaquin Phoenix made less than half of that for Joker. And to think that Birds of Prey isn't even part of the main DC cinematic universe? Take note. Those 10 million bucks were just for one of her major projects. She's got about three other multi-million dollar movies to her name, plus countless endorsements giving her an endless supply of paychecks month after month. So with all these income streams, one might think it's safe to bet that Margot Robbie is just one of those people who never checks the price tag and buys whatever she wants without hesitation. After all, it's almost impossible to blow off $24 million on a whim, right? But Margot's spending habits are not as glamorous as one might assume. In fact, she said in one interview that she doesn't even spend much money at all. She admitted that the typical spending habits of celebrity millionaires spook her and make her anxious, simply because she thinks it's crazy to spend a huge amount of money on things you don't need. Margot's thrifty lifestyle can be traced back to the kind of life she led before she became the huge superstar that she is today. You see, she was not born into a wealthy family, so she didn't grow up having the kind of luxury she can easily afford now. As a matter of fact, she revealed that as early as 12th grade, she was already deep in debt to her own mother. Margot was brought up by a single mother who had to work twice as hard to provide Margot everything she needed. So, for the longest time, Margot felt bad about asking her mom for money, so what she did was write everything she owed her mother, Sari, on a piece of paper and promised herself she would one day pay it all back. And that's exactly how Margot Robbie used the very first paycheck she got from an acting job, aka her super successful stint in the 2008 soap opera Neighbor. She could have easily treated herself to a luxury shopping spree, but she just couldn't spend any of that money on herself without giving back to her beloved mom first. She gave the whole amount to her mother to pay her back for everything she spent on Margot growing up. Because of her upbringing, it actually took Margot years to get accustomed to the nice things in life, like the Calvin Klein scent she uses on a daily basis now, on account of her being one of the brand's most prized endorsers. In one interview, she said, "Growing up, I never even had perfume. I was like, oh, one day when I'm all grown up and have the money, I'm going to wear perfume. I had one perfume, and I would save it for really, really special occasions, which meant I never actually wore it. So now it's one of those things like, I can wear perfume every day. I can afford to buy another one. I'm really lucky that I can. Now, when I have nice stuff, I don't save it anymore. I try to use it." And boy, did she learn to use the millions she painstakingly earned as an actress producer. One of Margot's biggest purchases was her posh beachside property in Venice, California. She paid $5 million for the chic beach house, and Margot was more than happy to let Vogue take a sneak peek inside for a 73 questions video. The interior looks heavenly and extra cozy, which is quite fitting for the actress's laid-back vibe. But before this major beach house splurge, Margot Robbie and her husband Tom Ackerley first bought a $2.73 million house in Los Angeles. This actually marked a very important milestone in the Australia-born actress's life. Before she became a Hollywood staple, Margot was still living in London and would simply travel to LA whenever she had a project or a movie to shoot. She'd kick it back in Airbnbs and hotels until she started getting back-to-back projects. And going back and forth between two continents simply became too unsustainable for her. So, getting the Hancock Park home was sort of a rite of passage that marked Margot's full acceptance of her stardom. And the mansion was an amazing representation of her star status, too. The home was decked out in marble and chrome fixtures all the way to the interior. WWE presented an exclusive look inside the house house back in 2017, when Robbie and Ackerley were first reported to have purchased it. But considering that Margot Robbie still considers Australia as her home continent, it shouldn't come as a surprise that she invested in a pretty awesome home in the land down under, too. Rumor has it that Robbie seriously inquired about a $1.3 million Byron Bay house in Australia. The sweetest part is that the estate was located close to the property where she and Ackerley had their secret wedding ceremony all those years ago. It remains unverified if Margot actually went on with purchasing the house, but it would be kinda dope if she did. Now, remember how Margot used up her first ever paycheck to pay her mom back? Well, that's not the extent of her spending on her closest family member. Apparently, Margot also paid off Sari's entire mortgage payment on their family home as a gift for her 60th birthday. So now, Margot's mom is enjoying her retirement years without any sort of debt to think about. Of course, Robbie eventually outdid herself by buying her mom a brand new place to live, but her mom surely won't forget Margot's sweet gesture of paying off her mortgage. Apart from spoiling her family rotten, Margot has also learned how to treat herself to something pretty every now and then. In an interview with Elle, Margot said she used one of her earliest huge paychecks to buy herself a Tiffany charm for her bracelet. She recalled, "When I got to New York for the first time, I took out a big paycheck, walked straight into Tiffany's on Fifth Avenue, and bought an airplane charm that goes on my bracelet. It was the best feeling ever. I got my little blue box, and I got it for myself." Needless to say, Robbie has acquired quite the taste for the finer things in life. After her first Tiffany's purchase, she started collecting bags. And not just any kind of bags. In fact, it's almost impossible to spot Robbie in public without a designer bag. She has a particular liking for Gucci bags, which is understandable since they frequently collaborate on her outfits. Many of her Gucci accessories also cost a minimum of $1,000 each, but she has also been spotted wearing Marc Jacobs, Stella McCartney, and Prada bags from time to time. On top of all that, Margot also likes to sport pricey shoes from a number of different designers. She and her Suicide Squad co-star, Cara Delevingne, were even spotted wearing matching Bertucci heels, which couldn't have come cheaper than $1,000 a pair. But you can guess the most unusual and most heartbreaking way Margot spends her fortune? Well, the answer is security. In an eye-opening interview with The Hollywood Reporter, Margot said a huge chunk of her paycheck for movies actually goes to ensuring her safety. She admitted that accepting bigger roles like Suicide Squad's Harley Quinn attracted a lot of stalkers and death threats, mostly from comic book fanboys who either projected upon Margot their Harley Quinn fantasies, or think she did such a bad job as Harley Quinn that she ended up ruining the anti-hero for them. Anyway, she said getting death threats has forced her to shell out thousands of dollars to have a security team do background checks to pin down whoever sent those threats to find out if it's someone actually capable of harming her, or if those threats are actually empty. She revealed that every background check costs her about $2,000, and she gets more than one death threat regularly. The situation is actually so bad that Margot wishes she knew this would happen before she even took the role. While Margot did enjoy being Harley Quinn, she said she's just not sure all this hassle was worth it. She said, "I would have taken all that into consideration before getting myself into this, because then you'd do a job that you can financially support that lifestyle of always having to run background checks and beefing up security measures. This means you can't just do indie films for the rest of your life because that one film back there changed everything, and now you have to be able to afford security." And that's why Margot wishes someone had explained to her the repercussions of taking on such a well-known and well-loved role. Instead, she had no idea what was coming and is now resenting the position she's been forced into, with thousands of hard-earned dollars coming out of her account month after month just to ensure her safety. So, there you have it. Apparently, Margot Robbie's highly successful film career comes with a hefty price tag. We're still glad she could still at least go on designer label shopping sprees to dispel all the bad vibes from all the D threats she's been getting since she became Harley Quinn.